census numbers show Jackson is losing neighbors by the thousands.
More than 11,000 people left the city in the last decade, but as 16 WAPT Scott Simmons reports, leaders say they're due for a comeback, Scott.
That's right. In fact, you look at downtown Jackson. It has had a recent number of development projects that gave people hope down here. There are others on the books that are stalled because of the economy, but they are needed because, according to the 2010 census, more people chose to leave Jackson than those who moved here.
Jackson's population fell by a total of 11,000 people over the last 10 years. Former residents like Gay Williams now lives in cities like Brandon.
If it was safer to live there in the area where I grew up, I would live there. But it's not safe.
Not just crime, but I've noticed that even downtown, they have closed down a lot of places. And so it's not much to do.
From 2000 to 2010, Jackson shrunk from 184,000 to 173,000. The population erosion was mirrored by problems in downtown Jackson. That departure of business was offset recently by new developments like the Pinnacle Office Complex, the King Edward, and the Standard Life. The Ferris Street Entertainment District is the next attraction, but it has been stalled. Developer David Watkins says it will open in July, and he claims the city's trend of losing residents has already turned around.
You saw what happened when we put 40 units on the market with the King Edward and Standard Life. They're full. So if we had more downtown housing units, we could fill them up.
City Councilman Tony Yarbrough admits the city has to turn the tide on both education and the crime issue.
I think it's legitimate if that's their perception. The fact of the matter is that crime is new. Crime has been going on. It goes on here. It goes on in other places.
Yarbrough says it's a matter of marketing. Jackson has got to do a better job.
We have to do a better job as city leaders of, number one, selling the city of Jackson. Number two, making sure that we have a good product to sell.
And there's already been a good bit of marketing. When you look at King Edward, it is filled. And real estate agents will tell you, when people look at moving to areas like downtown Jackson, they look at things like property values and property taxes, also crime rate, and certainly the quality of the public education system in the area. What developers say down here is constantly improving. Live in downtown Jackson, Scott Simmons, 16 WAPT News.